The next part is trying to reduce vidge netting. One of the things about camcorders is that as you try to increase your camcorder optical zoom, the eye relief distance needed actually changes because the zoom lens is moving some of the lenses backwards and forwards. And so its focal point, its needed focal point, does not stay the same over the whole range. So let me show you that effect by zooming my camcorder. Currently, my setting is at 1x, and I'm going to gradually increase it. Notice how at a certain point, you start getting the weird edges. So by changing the distance between my camcorder to the scope, you can notice by pushing it in now, notice how the edges disappear again, because the optimal eye relief distance is different. And as I pull it back out, you'll be able to see the dark areas once again. And now let me increase the zoom further. Currently I'm at 4x. And if I move it, camcorder in, I'm able to get rid of the vidge netting effects once more. Now, at the higher camcorder zoom, it's harder to keep the camcorder aligned with the rifle scope. So that part can always be a bit of a challenge. But as I zoom out, you'll notice that at some distances, you'll essentially achieve an optimal zoom level for this camcorder magnification. Let me see if I can rotate out to get rid of the vision editing. That was a bit of a trickier issue here. Okay, that centers it once more. And I still get a very good sight picture here at about 3x now. And you just have to move the camcorder in and out as you increase or decrease the camcorder again to find the optimal eye relief distance for each setting.